Hoi hoi hoi! Welcome to a new video from Gear Outdoors. And this time I am at home because I am going to try to make myself a bucksaw. And for that I have some materials here which I will show you shortly. And that is basically what this video will be about, trying to make a bucksaw. So if you want to watch this and see how I do it, stay tuned. Okay, the things I am going to use today is these two pieces of wood. They are 50 centimeters from side to side. There's two of them. It is this piece of round wood which goes in between. And this longer one, I will cut off about maybe 20 centimeters or something to use for the tightening system later. I have my old knife. This is the first one I ever made. I have two screws, temporary solution for fastening the saw blade and the saw blade itself. A pencil for marking, a screw machine with a wooden drill. I have wood color, three pieces, a sponge for applying the color to the wood, some piece of paracord for the tightening, sandpaper. This is 240 grit, a measurement, a file, and a saw to cut. So, I am ready! Step one, to take these pieces of wood, mark 20 centimeters and make holes for the round piece. Step two, make a hole. Step three is to mark and cut the slit for the saw blade. Now I have cut two slits They are 2 centimeters. And I can put my saw blade through here. Step number 5. Take the ends of the round piece and make it slightly thinner to fit inside the hole. And I will also cut it down to size to the length of the saw blade. So I start off by assembling the saw blade in my bucksaw frame, and then I measure, and it is 44 centimeters inside. So I will make this one 45 because it needs to go into the wood. And then we cut it. So now I have cut this down to 45 centimeters, and I will now make these ends a little bit thinner to fit inside the holes. You can use the knife and sharpen it down or cut off some surplus wood, and then finish it off with the sandpaper. This is what it looks like after step 6. This is just a test assembly, no attachments made. I have just sanded the round wood because it was a little bit worn on the outside, just to make it nicer looking. I will color it later with my color here, and I think it will look good. Step 7 is to make small notches in the top here for the tightening rope, the power cord I will use for tightening. And I start by measuring either about 20 centimeters from the hole or 5 centimeters from the top. I will do 5 centimeters from the top. There you have the markings. This was not very clear. There you have the markings, and I will make notches all the way around for the paracord. So now I have made some notches all the way around, and I will sand them down so they are not very sharp. So I tear off a small piece of sanding paper. I use my lumber pencil. I just wrap it around like this. And I use this for sanding the notches. And as you can see, the marks are left here, so I will just also quickly sand them off, because I don't like them there when I'm adding the color later. Like that. And on the other one. And then we have to clean this mess also. I see you when I have done that. And now we are ready for step 8. And step 8 will be to take this piece and cut it down to length so that it fits between the notches and the hole. So it needs to be slightly longer than this distance. This is 20. I will make this one 25. And then I just cut this off. There you go. I cut this off now, and with a pointed end, just for looks basically, and to take up a little less room. Now I'm gonna sand this. This is a little bit thick, but it's okay. Now it's finished sanded, and the only reason I do this is because I am at home now and I have the time and the tools to do it. If I had done this bushcraft, I wouldn't bother to sand it. Step 9, drill 2 holes in the top for the tightening rope. So there you have it, 2 holes for the paracord when I'm going to tighten the bucksaw. The next step is to make one of these sides slightly more comfortable for the hand. And here in the bottom I have this notch, the slit for the saw blade, and I am going to be holding right above it, because you see the hole here is in the middle or on the inside. So I'm going to be holding it like this when I'm sawing. You can see better there, I guess. So on this side, I'm gonna see if I can make a more comfortable handle grip. So I am just gonna roughly mark where my hand goes, like so. And then I'm gonna use the file to round off the corners to make it more easy on the hand, you can say.
Now I have shaped the handle part and I have sanded it down so it grips good in my hand. So the next part. Is to assemble everything and see how it looks. So, there you have it. I will, for the next step, I will cut off some surplus cord and I will color it. So I will see you at the end. I am pretty pleased with this. The finished result. So in a future video I will bring it with me and try it out in the woods. I have also planned to maybe see if I can put some leather around the handle just for the show basically and for better grip. So I hope you like it. I surely do. And I hope you have liked this video, and if you do, don't forget to like, hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell so that you get notifications when I upload new videos. I hope to see you also in the next one. Goodbye!